Hi guys, in the previous video we created the Dixie library, right? So in this today's video, so we'll see how to create the constructor. Okay, so what are constructors? So before our driver get called, if you want to perform something, so then the constructors will be used in the EDK2. Okay, so if I go back to this spec, so here we can see, right? So define constructor, right? So define a constructor, it is exactly similar to a library, but it will have the one more attribute called the constructor and followed by a function name. Okay, so how it is, how this will be linked, we'll see. Okay, so let me open the previous code. I'll go to downloads folder, EDK2 underscore demo. I will open the source in the VS code. Okay, so in the previous video, we took the CPU .inf file, right, to create the Dixie sample lib. Okay, so where this Dixie sample lib got created, so this is under emulator package library, here we have, right? So now what I'm going to do, so I will replicate this, okay, and I will rename this to Dixie sample lib. Okay, so now this will have its associated C file and the INF file. So let me rename this as well. Okay, so now here we have our base name. So this also I'm going to change. This also library class also I'm going to change, and the source also I'm going to change. Okay, so since this is a new INF file, so we had to create the GUID. Control Shift P, insert GUID, and transform to uppercase. Okay, so now the constructor which we are creating is for the Dixie module. It will be same process for the PA as well. Okay, so now, so we got the library class, we got the module name, we got the GUID as well, right? So now to this defines section header, we have to add one more attribute called the constructor. Okay. Constructor. Okay, I'm going to copy this. Okay, so for this constructor, it requires the value, which is the function name. Okay. So let me copy this. Okay, so Dixie sample to constructor. Okay, so this is going to be my API name. Okay, so I will copy this API name, and here I'm going to do this. Okay, so this is not going to return anything. Okay, so we'll see this. Yeah, so this is the API, right? So this API, this constructor has to return some data, right? So what it has to return, so if you go back to this one, so we are doing for the Dixie driver, right? So this is the API. Okay, so I will copy this. Okay, so let me rename this API. So let me do some alignment. Okay, so now, okay, so we got, so it has to return some data, right? So in this case, UEFI status. So return UEFI underscore success. Okay, so let's fix this underscore errors. There will be one master header file which will have this defines and all. So I'm trying to find that. Yeah, so here we have this UEFI.h, right? So then here, hash include UEFI slash. Oh, it's directly under md package slash include, right? So we can directly include this. UEFI.h. Okay. And then here, so in this case, the constructor, so we will create some, suppose uint 32 variable 1, and then uint 32 some variable 2. Okay, so I will initialize this variables. Variable 1 is equal to 10. Variable 2 is equal to 50. Okay, so debug underscore info, some keyword, Dixie sample to constructor, result is equal to percentage d slash n. Okay, so variable 1 plus variable 2. Okay, so what this constructor is doing, so this constructor will have these two variables and it will print the addition of these two variables. Okay, so now where we will call this constructor, right? So now before we call this, so this does not have any additional h files needed, right? Because this constructor header files will be auto generated, so I will show you that as well. Okay, so now this constructor we have to link in the DAC file. Okay, so where we will going to add that, so it should be under emulator package.dac file. It's a library, right? So here we have this runtime drivers, UEFI driver, Dixie driver, and all that. So let me add it here. So the library class name, this library class name, it is coming from here, Dixie sample to lib. Okay. And then followed by a pipeline character, emulator package, library, Dixie sample to lib, Dixie sample to lib dot inf. Okay, so now we can include that here. Okay, so before I include, so if I go to this cpu.inf, right? So let's go back to the build folder, IA32, emulator, cpu runtime Dixie, debug, autogen.h file. Okay, so in the autogen.h file, so we have one function declaration which is initialize CPU. Okay. And if I go back to the autogen.c file, so here you can see there are multiple functions. Let me go back to the top. Yeah. So these are some variables which is defined, but let me come down. Yeah. So here we have this UEFI boot service table, we have runtime service table, some constructors and all, right? But let's look at this one, process library constructor lib list, right? Sorry, process library constructor lib. Okay, so meaning, so whenever this driver is going to execute, okay, so this constructor list will get called. Okay, so in this case, we have this UEFI service table, this function will get called, and then this one, this one, this one, this one, after one by one, it will get called. Okay, so now here you can see once this constructor lib is get complete, so then here we have entry point. Okay, so once that constructor is completed, so it will call this module entry point. Okay, so now let's stick to this constructor now. So currently we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 functions. Okay, so this CPU INF has the 6 constructors. Okay, so now let's add our new constructor, which is Dixie sample to lib. Okay, so let's build the source, open the command prompt, EDK setup. Okay, so do the build. It's about to finish. Yeah, build got completed. So now let's go back to this same autogen.c file and h file. So there is no change in the h file. But if you come back to the c file, so here we can see there is a new constructor got added up here to this constructor list. So this is Dixie sample to constructor. Okay, so where this is coming from? This is coming from the library which we had created now, which has this constructor. Okay, so meaning, so first this function will get called, then this, at the end of the constructor, it will get called this Dixie sample to constructor. Okay, so now how we are going to confirm that? So open the build folder, go to emulator IA32, VS19, IA32, open the command prompt here, winhost, redirect to boot.log, 2> 1. Okay, so it got booted to UEFI shell. So I will close the terminal. So let's open the boot.log. Okay, so this is our cpu.efi. Okay, so as you can see, before our entry point, so if I look at where this message is coming from, or maybe where this message is coming from, it is coming from this cpu.c file. Okay, so where we have this entry point, right? So before this entry point get called, our constructors will get called. Okay, so in this case, we have this Dixie sample constructor. So what that Dixie sample constructor is doing, so it created two variables and it is added this sum, and that sum is printed here. Okay, so now as you can see, Dixie sample to constructor and the result is 60. Okay, so now what we did, so if I go back to the C file, so this constructor is going to take the two arguments, which is this image handler and the system table. So this image handler and the system table is needed for the Dixie driver, whereas for the PI drivers, it needed the file handle, which is a PI file handle, and the PI services. Okay, so if it is a base, so then we don't need any argument, but we should always use this EFI status where it should return the status of that constructor, whether it has been passed or failed. Okay, so similar to the constructor, we have the destructors. Okay, so what the destructor will do is, so it will, once that module execution is completed, so this will the destructor will be get called, and that in it will perform some task. Okay, so maybe suppose say during the constructor I'm going to create some global variable. Okay, and during the destructor I'm going to clear that global variable. Okay, so it can be used for any other purpose. Okay, so what we did today, so we created a constructor of a type Dixie driver. Okay, which is called Dixie sample to constructor, having a library class Dixie sample to lib. So which is going to take two arguments, image handle and the system table, because it's a Dixie driver, and it is created in two variables, and it is printing the addition of those two numbers. Okay, and it is returning the success, and this constructor we are adding in the cpu.inf. So before this entry point, which is initialize CPU get called, the constructor will be get called, and then the CPU initialize CPU function will get called. And the similar results we have observed in the BIOS logs, as well as we can observe in the autogen.c file of the CPU. That's it for today. Thank you.